Hi. Today I'd like to talk with you about the YouTube user known as McGrawTim123 and his history on the internet. It has been one of starts and fits. Here one moment, gone the next. Constant deletions of content. Not because YouTube had to remove it, but because McGrawTim123 had to remove it. Self-deleting, perennially, weekly, self-deleting. Now, what does this say about a man's psyche? Clearly, some Vietnam trauma is still lingering. I think the self-deleting equates to covering one's tracks. For in his mind, I think he's being followed through the jungle by the Viet Cong. And he doesn't want footprints still there. So just like a soldier might use a swath of leaves to cover up their footprints, Tim McGraw perennially deletes his videos. So you don't know he was there unless you were there at the same time he was there, in which case you would have captured him and taken him to a little hellhole where he would have to hide his buddy's watch up his ass for 5 years until he could give it to his kid who didn't appreciate it. So, seeing things from the McGrawTim123 perspective isn't always easy. First of all, most of us aren't old enough to even have that frame of reference in mind. I had to look up Vietnam and several books to even know what was bugging Tim so much. So, when evaluating why he does this, I think it truly does come back to Vietnam. Now, he's not a veteran. Tim's a hippie. Tim's a hippie who acts like a really freaked out veteran. There's a contrast there, which is perplexing, a little beguiling, and no small bit amusing. You see, Tim has PTSD from Vietnam, but from not being in Vietnam. The whole process of simply living through the era of Vietnam has made Tim an honorary Vietnam traumatized PTSD veteran. But it comes out in weird ways. It doesn't come out in Tim breaking into a cold sweat and freaking out in his house. It manifests in him weekly deleting everything he produces. Figuring that, there is a second aspect to it, and that is bad comments. He doesn't like people leaving him negative comments. This is a lot like the protesters to the Vietnam War in the 60s and 70s, 80s to an extent, who didn't respect the government and by extension transferred that to the soldiers. So, Tim avoiding the occasional negative comments is like a soldier, veteran, PTSD, wanting to just avoid a public who is going to diss them for trying to do what they thought was right. So you see, there's a lot of parallels here, and it all plays out in the guise of Tim's video making. He tells great stories, he has a lot to share, he's had a lot of life experience. But the manic way that he approaches the art of storytelling and the act of sharing is beguiling until you look at it with that reference. He is like a Vietnam vet with PTSD, and he's covering his trails because the government wants to insert a listening device in his rectum and take away all his freedom, as well as his printed money, and make him use credit, which they can constantly monitor. Also, he deletes everything because the personal contact of somebody coming up to him and saying something that is not necessarily what he was expecting to hear. Why should anyone have to deal with that, you know? I mean, it's an example. There are so many things that we should be deleting. He is blazing a trail and then snuffing it. I mean, most of the time, we just think of the videos you make as some sort of trail, but blazing or not. But Tim blazes and then snuffs. Blazes and then snuffs. Almost like a magician saying, look what I can do. Poof, whoop. Poof, whoop. I can start the fire. I can put out the fire. It's showmanship. And I don't think you will find a clearer example of internet showmanship than the here blazing for one moment and totally gone the next stylings of McGraw Tim 123. I highly suggest you check him out on YouTube.